Connery in the red, and we have Gytis, Simonavicius in the blue. I hope I did that right. In the blue. I'm not going to say that again.
I'm glad you took that bullet for me.
Yeah. So, as you can see, viewers, we are in amateur. So, of course, they're wearing the larger amateur gloves, the 8-ounce gloves, and shin pads. There will be no ground and pound in this, so no headshots on the ground. All body shots, I think. I'm not 100% sure, but Stuart Davis, our very good referee here, will know. He'll be explaining that to their corner right now. To the fighters, apologies.
He knows exactly what the rules are.
I mean,
he told me a minute ago.
To be fair, he always knows. If there's one man who knows, Stuart Davis.
Thank God he's the man that knows as well.
And here we go. Lightweight, 71 kilos. Three-minute rounds. The boys get to go.
Straight in.
Yeah, look at that. Volume of punches.
Jack, wasting no time.
Connery almost touched gloves and went. There, he gets a nice takedown, but Gytis is back on his feet. The overhook there from Connery.
Just trying to relax and take a little bit of stock here is Gytis, but I don't think he's going to have enough time.
No.
Beautiful overhand.
Great 1-2 there from Connery. Gytis returns fire. Another great 1-2 with a third shot. Connery already got his range.
Needs a little bit of head movement in there. Does Gytis. Nice little body shot there from Jack.
Return fire from Gytis. We already got a bloody nose on Gytis, I'm not sure, but I wouldn't be surprised. Nice lead left hook from Connery.
I feel like Gytis is one of those that he just bites down on his mouth guard and can't get knocked out.
I mean, these kids are going to be tough, but it's going to take a lot. Remember, that kind of pace coming out of the gate, it's going to... Oh, lovely straight right down the pipe there from Connery. Having a significantly more successful night. Lovely jab. Look at that.
Really snapped, didn't it?
Yeah. Stuart Davis keeping a close eye on this fight. Nice leg kick on the end of that combination from Gytis.
Jack does have a little cut above his right eyebrow. Tiny little one. Not sure where that came from.
Yeah. Both young men looking a little bit more tired now. Pace has slowed down. I think Connery's gonna. He's got a great pair of hands on him for a young lad.
He certainly does.
He's caught Gytis on. Oh, we've got a timeout.
No.
This happens quite a lot at the kind of semi-pro amateur level.
Have a look at his right eyebrow if you get a second.
Yeah, a little bit of an issue with the shin guard, but Stuart Davis fixes it like the pro he is. Gets him back to the action, they touch gloves. Oh, Connery throwing that straight right, 1-2. Very disciplined with his striking, with his hands, he comes, throws beautiful straight shots.
Interesting, neither have been too fussed about taking this to the floor at the moment.
No, not at all.
Nice little body shot there from Jack.
Yeah.
Gytis still trying to land combinations.
Oh, good hands there from Gytis. Look at that.
He's not throwing single shots ever.
No,
big head kick.
Oh, the crowd can feel the heat turn up here. I think what's happening is Connery's got a little bit more zing behind these punches than Gytis. Gytis landing some lovely combos, but just not doing the damage.
Oh. He's having a lot of success with that right high kick.
What a first round.
Very good, very good.
First round goes to Connery, in my mind.
I agree.
Started fast, continued. Some lovely, lovely striking, lovely hands. Throwing fast and frequent.
Very effective striking as well.
Live behind, had a nice jab. I'd like to see him use it a little bit more. I think that it's MMA. I think Gytis must know at this point that Utopia's corner was saying that you're going to lose this fight if it stays on the feet. Use your hands, close the distance, take the shot, get it down. Let's change this up. Let's take the second round.
Absolutely. It'd be interesting. Don't know how much studying he'd have done of his opponent. It could be uncharted territory. He could know what his ground game's like. I'm excited to find out.
Silky smooth, that voice. Right, here we go, round two. Right, let's see if the strategy changes. If I was Connery and it's corner, I'd say, look, this is working for us. Keep it going. Use those hands. Work behind the jab.
Let's see if there's a change in game plan.
No, Connery working behind that jab and cross nicely. Connery was the one who took the shot. Gets a lovely takedown.
Interesting. Now we'll see what the ground games are like. Straight into mount, though.
Oh, I think he's going to look for that arm lock.
He is. There it is.
Oh, he misses the head.
Oh!
Can he keep it? I think Gytis is going to come up into full guard. Connery's going to look for that triangle now. He does.
He is. There it is. It's in.
He needs to pull on that shin. He does. And let's go again. He needs to lock that shin up.
Slightly harder with the pads on.
Oh, that is a real issue, isn't it?
Needs to get that arm across if he can.
He's going for it now. He gets it locked up.
This
could well be the end.
Can he get that arm across? Looks to hook the leg.
Yeah, but he needs to just push his hips up so he can swing that arm. Oh, he turns the corner. This is going to be tight, but Gytis is a tough kid. If it's not on, he's not going to be tapping.
He's got to get that arm across.
I think I can hear his corner saying exactly that. Is he going to go for a mounted triangle? He is. Oh, yep. Is he going to come up? No. Gytis not letting him. While that arm is across, he's probably got a very good defensive position here. But there Connery looks
there
for that
is.
Arm. He's going to pull it across. Sink it down. Now lock it up.
He's going for the arm bar.
Oh, the position here is no good for Connery. Keeps it loose. What will Connery do now? Is he going to mount that position? He's got to listen to his corner.
He's got to try and pull that head in and close that space.
I think we might see this round end with Gytis in the triangle, but not tapping. Oh, he is stubborn. Oh, and he lets go of that triangle. Gytis is out, but he's gone for the omoplata instead.
Oh,
Connery
we don't
comes
see that
up.
A lot.
Gytis turns.
Rolls out of it. Beautiful.
Wow, what a combination. Look at this. We're going to see a standing rolling anaconda here from Connery. No, he just drags his opponent down, looks for
the back.
Oh,
lovely
slick
stuff.
Jiu-jitsu.
Lovely stuff.
He's working this round. He's showing formidable skills to such a young chap. Oh, Gytis is up on his feet. Lovely done.
Excellent.
Survives again.
Last 10 seconds.
Yeah, this has been an excellent round here from Connery. Oh, looks for the takedown, the trip, but fails it.
Really dominant there from Jack Connery.
Yeah. What a round. Connery walks back with two rounds in the bag, I think.
Absolutely.
Both young men looking pretty tired as they head into third round. I'm not surprised.
Oh, I'm not surprised either. It's interesting where obviously we talked about in the end of the first round about that Gytis needs to think about taking this fight to the floor, but turns out that's not a good idea.
Well, I don't know. I mean, look, I still would if I was Gytis. I mean, what he needs to do is he needs to initiate, he needs to not be taken down. He wants to be on top, because that's the only area of the game that we haven't yet seen. If he can take this fight to the floor himself, stay on top, secure good position, look for the submission himself, that is his route to victory. I don't think he's gonna win this on the feet at this point. Of course, never say never. But I think we're gonna see more of the same. Connor's gonna dominate on the feet here. We might even see Connor look to take this fight to the mat again. Or I think what we're seeing here is a little bit more patient striking from Connor.
Yeah, both men.
He's looking just to score nice, which it is, lovely.
Lovely. Gytis taking a big deep breath there, fatigued.
Yeah, both boys' mouths open, not surprised. Yeah. Again, simple shots here from Connery.
Laboured left hook there from Gytis.
Wow!
Big right hand again.
Connery scoring in bunches right now. He's pretty much landing everything he's throwing with those hands.
The fight was just moving into a little bit of a lull, but then Jack reminded us all that we're still here.
Joey, for such a young lad, he's very mature in pacing his fight in here.
Absolutely. He's extremely well-rounded.
Yeah, he's doing very well to just attack, step back off that attack. He's not getting carried away now. He's also tired with his hands down his ankles at the moment, but needs to pick those up. I think he's cruising himself to a win here, but looks for the takedown. Oh, he's got his back here. Gytis is in trouble now.
He is. He might be going for a ride.
I think we're going to see it. Connor lets go. Looks to strike.
There it is. Drags him down. Slips into mount.
Knee on belly. Into mount. Oh.
How much time has he got?
I think we're watching the end of the fight here.
We may well be.
No ground and pound, remember, so only submission from this position. Well, I said no ground and pound. You can hit the body.
To the body. The head. He's going for that arm again.
He is. Oh,
and he's missed it again. Oh, he's corrected.
Oh, he rolls belly down for that arm lock. Gytis looking to survive it. Is he going
to? Oh, he's thinking. Oh! So close. Great fight. Great fight.
Good fight. 14 and 15
years old. Unbelievable.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Oh, it's my turn, mate. Yeah, I'd love one, yeah. I mean,
Simonavicius.